Previously on Profit.
You're not to waste another second of company time pursuing anything to do with Jim.
I didn't realize Pete knew your stepmother.
Stepmother? She's an interior decorator.
I think I found myself that sugar man. I get him in my pocket, is it ever gonna mean a heap of trouble for you?
Sykes is an altruist not interested in our company's perks, but neck deep in a secret deal with Pete Grayson.
I thought things would get better when Pete quit drinking.
I want you right now, or I swear to God I'll start screaming and never stop.
Being a woman alone in a man's world is no easy task.
Anna Clayton Kistrell, co-founder of Dynamite, the wildly successful chain of food and music clubs. Despite everything she's achieved, she still lives in fear. Separated from Ray Kistrell, her husband of 7 years, Anna has been subjected to a reign of romantic terror. Unsigned notes calling her an evil slut. Blood on her car.
Who's there?
Well, it's enough to unhinge anyone.
Stay the hell away from me.
Anna.
Oh, God. Jim.
I'm sorry, did I frighten you?
No, it's just... I thought it was Ray.
Only me.
I don't know if I can do this.
You can do this. You're going to sit next to me, and you're going to be completely safe. Okay?
Come on. Anna? Morning. You look wonderful.
After months of vigorous negotiations, Grayson and Grayson has finally closed a deal to acquire Dynamite, which Anna and her estranged husband Ray own 50-50. Now, the deal should have been a breeze, but when Anna and Ray separated, Raymond got cold feet.
Well, this is a momentous occasion. Pete?
Welcome to G&G.
Our friend Sykes has been point man on Ray, and after countless hours listening to Ray's marital problems, has finally gotten him to the table.
I can't sign.
I got a pen.
I can't do this. I love you too much, Anna.
Ray, we've been through all this.
What did I do? I don't understand.
You mean other than scare the hell out of me?
I'm not doing those things. I mean, why would I? I love you. I won't sign. Not until she comes back to me.
Our personal relationships are more important than any business deal. I'm going to hold you both in my prayers until the right solution presents itself. And if it doesn't, well, it just wasn't meant to be. I publish this acquisition in the annual reports. 200,000 copies go out to the shareholders next week.
Ray signed a deal memo. He gave me his word he'll sign the contract.
So you told me, Sykes. It was just a formality. So you all told me! The board expects this to go through. The stock is up $3 in anticipation. Ray signs the contract before the annual reports go out, or the three of you are looking for new jobs.
When it comes right down to it, big business is all about opportunity. Here's a terrific one to remove Sykes from our midst. When those in control lose control, it sets everyone on edge and causes some of us to slip over a line we wouldn't ordinarily cross. As an innocent woman can really only be seeking one thing. Control. resists. Ask any police officer and he'll tell you, the worst violence is always domestic. When two people fall out of love and into hate, they become vulnerable to all manner of passions, fears, and if someone's watching carefully, manipulation. In a case like this one, you just know somebody's bound to wind up dead.
I didn't want some guy following me around everywhere. Another guy, I should say.
Someone I want you to meet. Anna, this is Hal. He's your new best friend. Anybody tries to pull a stunt like they did last night, Hal's gonna snap their neck, okay? Come on.
Jim, I was so scared.
I know. I mean, I can only imagine.
Don't you know you're supposed to be worried about the deal, not me?
I am. I'm concerned about the deal. My bonus that goes along with it. But until we catch this guy, until we're sure whether it's Ray or not...
It has to be Ray. Who else could it be?
Any one of 1,000 guys who drink in your bar and think they deserve a girl like you.
Yeah. Ray never did anything that weird before we split up. He was a little insecure, but... I always chalked that up to his first wife. She left him, ran off with another man.
No, sorry. The yen is falling. Can I borrow your pen?
Oh, yeah, sure. Jim, thanks for listening.
Morning.
Good morning, Mr. Sykes.
Jeff, you any closer to getting ready to sign those contracts?
I'm working on it.
Anything I can do to help?
I'd like to know for a fact Ray isn't stalking her.
Chaz didn't say anything about that being relevant to us keeping our jobs.
It's relevant to me.
So is getting fired. Better update their resume, Jeff.
Hey! Chaz Grayson's driver?
Find out what happened to my car.
Bobby Stokowski, I redecorated your brother's office.
Oh, yes. How are you?
Good. And late for my Bible class. Nice to see you.
Who the hell's that? What the hell?
Give me a wallet! Give me a wallet! I'm going. Don't shoot me. Don't shoot me.
Oh, Lord. Are you all right?
You saved my life.
Ray, look me in the eye and tell me it isn't you that's stalking Anna.
Jeffrey, you've known me for a while now. I swear to God, it isn't me.
Okay. Then I can say this with a clear conscience. Sign the damn contracts, Ray.
It isn't that simple.
I still love her.
Sometimes people need...
I know.
A little space.
All right, I give her the space. What happens? Some filthy bastard starts harassing her. Cops, lawyers get in it. All of a sudden, I can't come within 500 yards of her without permission. I can't even come into my own club the night that she's here. I just want her back.
There's only one way. Let go.
Yeah, well, I'm not so good at that.
Just think about it. I gotta go.
You work with this guy, Prophet, Anna trusts him. Can't you just tell him?
What?
That Anna should take me back. I'm suffering for something I didn't do here. I'm sure he wouldn't want that.
No. I'm sure he would.
Thank you.
You're welcome. I'm so glad you could come. I believe you know my junior vice president, Jim Prophet.
It's nice to see you, Miss Tikowski. How do you do?
Oh, I'm just fine, thank you. You're looking well yourself.
I just wanted to be able to thank you in person. Here, take a seat.
Oh, my, you're in pain. You hadn't even touched your pills, huh?
No, the, doctor sent all these painkillers over, and they just slow down the healing process.
These are real bad for you. May I? I never take drugs of any kind, but I always keep a little Livia handy for really bad pain. It's organic, completely harmless.
Thank you. I don't believe in any of that stuff either.
Please. I'd just feel so much better if I knew you were getting some relief.
Well, if it makes you feel better.
Jim, could you get us some water, please?
This is unbelievable. I could barely button my shirt this morning.
Here, take a couple whenever you feel poorly. What?
You look like an angel.
Aren't you sweet? I'm just so grateful that you're all right.
I'll call you.
This man gives some fine pharmaceuticals.
Bobby, I want you to tell me what you put in the pills you gave Chaz and who you hired to hit him.
The pills are a little love potion of mine. Parsley and mint to make the breath sweet. Codeine and morphine to make the mind melt. As for the other, ain't none of your damn beeswax. I done told you I was gonna get myself a sugar daddy.
Bobby, listen. If you wanna play this game along, fine. You just better be prepared to lose.
Oh, I know you'll cover for me, baby. Now, give Mama some money.
Mrs. Tikowski, I've been calling you all morning. I'm Joanne Meltzer, head of corporate security. We met before, just before your husband died so suddenly in the hospital.
Of course, I remember.
I need to talk to you about Charles Grayson's mugging.
Well, I've already spoken with the police.
Our resources are a little more comprehensive than theirs. It'll only take a minute. My office is on the 18th floor. There's nothing to be afraid of. Unless, of course, you mugged him yourself.
It's got to be 5 o'clock somewhere.
Pete's wife Nora told us he quit drinking.
Mr. Prophet smiles politely.
Pete, I think we should take a run at Anson Electronics.
You mean if we're still working here next week? Anson,
Yeah, I got a file on them. Where'd I put it?
Iced tea? I wonder how long Pete's been sober.
Oh, yeah.
And wanting everyone to think that he's not.
Anson. Beating the Asians at their own game. We should grab them. Probably should run it by my brother, Mr. Toadhead.
Hi. What is it?
I love you, man. I love you.
I've been monitoring Ray Kestrel's florist like you told me, and he's sending Anna 2 dozen roses today.
I wonder if she's not sure about him. Call my florist, have him add $500 worth, and sign the card, whether you stay or go. I love you, Ray.
Playing Cupid?
Yeah, I got everything I need for now.
Okay, just get back to me as soon as you can. Thanks.
Those guys are...
Police detectives. They're talking to Joanne.
So?
So, she knows you aren't at a Bible class. What did she ask you?
What I was doing there at that hour. How come I fired the gun there instead of the mugger? You know, typical police BS. She can't touch me.
She can touch you.
Not what you're looking out for me, baby boy. There. Ain't that pretty? Mrs. Roberta Grayson.
Bobby, did you call this mugger from any phone traceable to you?
No, I ain't stupid.
Oh, well, that's a relief. Okay. I need you to give me his name and address.
What for?
What for? Because you know why? You did what you always do. You acted fast, you thought slow, and you left a big mess behind. Now, if you don't help me clean it up, I'll cut you loose, and we'll both take our chances with the police. How would you like that? What's it gonna be?
Oh, Jimmy. I just love it when you get surly. He goes by the name of Satchmar, and he stays at the Marble Arch Hotel. Hey, you got time for a quickie? And somebody's gonna get a spanking. Nice and hard.
Anna Castrell on 3.
Come in. How are you?
I'm good. Ray sent me thousands of flowers.
That was nice.
I guess. Sorry it took me so long to get back. What's up?
I stole something from you. It's your pen. Accidentally, I must have put it in my pocket yesterday when I was taking notes.
That's where it went. I looked everywhere.
I'm sorry. Listen, I'm gonna be working in the office till about midnight tonight. Thought maybe I could swing by afterwards, drop it off. It's your night there tonight, right?
I'll be here till 2:30. Come on by.
Great. I'll see you tonight.
See ya.
Let's call Ray. You have your notes?
Hello.
Hi, this is Gail Kohner calling from G&G. I'm just double-checking. You'll meet Anna at the club tonight, 2:15 sharp, right after closing?
What meeting? What are you talking about?
The spot check on the night's receipts. I know that it's late, but we had to wait until closing.
There's a meeting with Anna?
I'm sorry, who is this?
This is Ray Kestrel. I own the club. Nobody told me.
I am terribly sorry, Mr. Kestrel. I thought I was calling someone else. Will you please ignore the message?
Who is this? Hello? Hello?
You are getting really good.
Joanne, you used to be a cop. If a husband's a stalker and he gets his wife back, is she still in danger?
More than ever. She left once, she can leave again. To make this restaurant deal, you have to get the husband and wife back together, don't you? Well, it's nice to see you wrestling with this. Prophet wouldn't think twice. Guard your morals, Mr. Sykes. They tend to disappear around here pretty fast.
Pete, I asked you a question.
I told you. I'm going to a seminar.
I can tell when you're lying. It's one of the things I've always liked about you.
I'm going back east to see Uncle Arthur.
My uncle?
Look, I can't say any more about it right now. I don't want to jinx it. But believe me, our lives are going to change for the better.
Does Chaz know that...
Nobody knows. So you can't breathe a word of this to anyone. Please. Trust me on this.
Hello.
How are you?
Good. Thanks for bringing it back.
No problem.
Can I buy you a drink?
You know, I'd love to. I've got an early meeting in the morning.
Is that all you do is work?
Just about, yeah. Lovely flower.
Oh, I love flowers. But I'm not going to let him go to my head.
No, you're right not to. How's Hal working out?
Oh, he's the best. I never felt so safe.
Well, that makes me happy. I'll talk to you soon, okay?
All right, see ya.
Bye-bye.
Bye.
Do me a favor. Check out in the alley. I thought I saw a car pulling in back there. It looked like Ray's. It may be nothing, but... Just look, okay?
Take me home, Hal. I'm beat.
Get away from her! Get up!
Ray?
Easy, take it easy. God, I'm gonna get my...
No, 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 don't leave me, don't leave me. Don't leave me.
The things I do for love. Pain. The Buddhist monks believe it exists only to be embraced. That we must fold it into our lives alongside pleasure and remember that both are fleeting.
Sure. You okay, Jeff?
I'm just fine, thanks.
Yeah, so we can all breathe a little easier about our jobs now.
I can anyway. You'll be unemployed.
What do you mean?
Well, Chaz said he'll fire us if the deal doesn't go through. But after last night, you heard about Ray saving Anna from that stalker, didn't you?
Oh, yeah. I'm on the way over to see Anna right now, as a matter of fact.
Mighty convenient Ray showing up like that.
Yeah, it's got me concerned.
So you're saying you don't buy it either?
No, I don't. I'm not saying Ray set this up. I'm just saying let's be careful. We should let the police handle this, okay?
God, Jim, it was horrible.
Just be smart, okay?
Okay.
Bobby, when I ran out of those pills you gave me, I started to panic.
Coming by so fast.
You know, this isn't all just physical. You've also got a lot of emotional misalignment. I could feel it. You're just holding so much pain.
You gotta let it out, Chaz, or it's gonna kill you. Come on now. Just let it out. Come on. Let it out. Yeah, I know you want to. You want to cry, don't you? You ain't cried your whole life, probably, but you want to now, don't you, honey? Yeah, yeah. Come on now, just come on. Cry for me, baby. Let it all out. Oh, yeah. You're still a man if you cry. Bigger, better man than ever. So come on now. Come on. Cry for me.
She didn't make any other calls from her hotel room?
Sorry, that's it.
Did you check the payphones?
Payphones.
Ernie, in the lobby, you know, on the street around the hotel. If Bobby Stokowski hired the guy that mugged Chaz, she had to talk to him. She didn't do it from the hotel room.
Nora. Hi.
Hi.
Sit down, please. How are you?
I thought things would get better when Pete quit drinking, but instead... I can't keep it down anymore, and Pete keeps talking about him and talking about him, and I can't. He's...
Who?
Uncle Art.
Arthur McLean, head of McLean Limited. But the McLeans and the Graysons have always hated each other. Why would Pete be talking to him?
So, Pete's talking to him?
He's meeting him right now on some kind of deal.
Well, that's good.
I don't see my uncle, ever. Not since...
Nora. I don't want you to tell me anything that's gonna make you uncomfortable.
No, I want to. I was 12. Staying with Uncle Art and my cousins in the summer. He always liked me, treated me like a grown-up. One night I snuck down to the boathouse to smoke. He followed me, started touching me. He smelled like gin and sweat. I froze up.
I'm sorry.
You all right?
I'm fine. It just hurts me to see you like this.
Oh.
All right, I give you every payphone near Bobby Stokowski's hotel. And what are you looking for, exactly?
Something that doesn't fit. Something that might lead to, oh, Broad Street.
The drug hotel.
And what about it?
There's a lot of calls from a four-star hotel to a no-star hotel. Find out what room.
Oh, now she wants the room number.
Who is it?
Friend of Bobby's. We need to talk.
Yeah? What?
I know she hired you to mug Charles Grayson.
Bitch turned on me? Where is she?
Room's registered Michael John Satchmar. Priors on possession, dealing,
assault, carjacking.
That's our guy. I'm on my way. Meet me there.
She was sloppy.
I'm here to clean up.
Clean up what?
There's something I want you to see, Michael. It's in the briefcase. Why don't you open it up?
I got no friends.
You do now. Doug, come on in.
Douglas Stark, this is your client, Michael Satchmore. Michael, say hello to your lawyer.
What is this?
There's $50,000 cash in that case. It's yours. If you confess.
Confess?
That's right.
You're gonna pay me to confess?
Yeah. To the mugging. And something else.
Yeah, what do I gotta be, the second gunman on the grassy knoll?
You've been stalking a woman. Her name is Anna Castrell. You didn't hurt her. You just scared her.
I don't know no Anna.
I'm offering you a job. You're going to be very well paid for it, and you don't have to talk to anybody. Your lawyer's going to do all your talking for you. He's got your journal right there.
My journal?
Yeah. It's a record of your obsession with Anna. How you first met her that night in her club. Couldn't stop thinking about her. You started following her everywhere she went. You saw her talking to Charles Grayson, and out of jealousy, you just had to beat him up.
You're telling me the $50,000 in the case is mine right now?
That's right. And 50 more the day you get out of jail. Now, the police are here. Michael, I'd say you've got less than a minute. They're gonna come charging through that door, arresting you for mugging. I don't think they're carrying any cash offers. What's it gonna be?
How much time I'll be doing?
9 months guaranteed.
100,000 now, 100,000 when I get out.
Michael, this is not a negotiation. It's my final offer and it stands.
And all I get to say to that is, God bless this wonderful country of ours.
Oh, Mike, there's just one more thing.
Mm-hmm. Oh! What, are you crazy?
I don't think so. Your lawyer will explain everything to you. Michael, it's really a pleasure to meet you. Good luck.
You Michael Satchmore?
Yeah?
We have some questions we'd like to ask you.
Come on in. Why don't you meet my lawyer?
The secret to closing any deal is to make it about more than just numbers. Make it a force to bring people closer to what they most desire in their lives. But some people are never satisfied.
Joy, tell me something. If everything worked out so great and everybody's so happy, why do I have a sick feeling in my stomach?
Ask Damien.
You look like a man whose conscience is bothering him.
I'm glad you know what a conscience is, Jim. You know, since you don't actually possess one.
You know, I've been meaning to get one. I've just been so tied up with work lately. Cheer up, Jeff. The deal's closed. A husband and wife are reunited. There's nothing to worry about.
Other than Anna's life.
Oh, right. Speaking of which, Ray likes to tell people his first wife left him. I wonder what the real story is there.
There's the cliff, Jeff. Now go be a good little lemming and jump off it.
Yes, Mr. Sykes. What can I do for you?
I need some information on the Susan Castrell drowning.
Oh, let me see. That was so long ago.
I know it was a long time ago, sir. But I was just wondering, if anyone at your paper can tell me if there was ever a police investigation, did anyone ever talk to Mr. Castrell?
Well, not that I recall. It was an accident. One kind of weird thing I remember, though.
What?
Folks at the lake said his wife was a real swimmer. Not just good, great. Said she qualified for the Olympics a few years before. Weird that somebody could swim like that and drown on such a puny little lake, huh?
That does hurt. Oh,
dear. Ooh. Just breathe. Just let all that tension go.
incredible.
Oh, roll over, let me do your front. Oops. What happened to that towel? No, I can't.
What? What's wrong?
You're a married man.
Bobby.
Look, I'm not gonna lie to you. I've done a lot of things in my marriage that I'm not proud of. But this, Bobby, this thing between us, I tell you, I felt things I never thought I could. And I know it's all because of you.
I'm feeling things too, you know that. So I gotta go. Please, don't be here when I get back.
You want to see me?
Jeff, yeah, come on in.
Our noble Mr. Sykes. We are sure gonna miss you around here.
You got a second?
Oops.
But somehow, I'm sure we'll muddle through.
Well, oops. You keep a spare shirt in your office, don't you? You better change it. Can't go to a products meeting looking like that.
You're absolutely right. You ever do any rock climbing, Jeff?
Can't say I have.
It's awful fun. It's dangerous. Mm. You know, my doctor says I'm lucky I didn't break anything.
You and that mugger both. He's got a big nasty bruise on his chest too, doesn't he? Just like yours.
Really?
I don't like coincidence, Jim. Especially when they end up wrapped in neat little packages. Always leaves me wondering, who did the wrapping?
You think I have something to do with the terrible things been happening to Anna and Chaz?
Ray's first wife didn't leave him. She drowned. While he sat on his boat 5 feet away.
No.
Yes. He killed her. But you've known that all along, haven't you? You've known that since the day this deal first started. So why tell me now? Can't be because you care about Anna or what her psycho husband's gonna do to her. It has to be so I'll tell her.
Jeff, if you stumbled across some sort of evidence here, I'm sure you're gonna do whatever your conscience tells you to do.
And when I do, Ray goes through the roof, then he goes to his old buddy Chaz, and I get fired.
For telling the truth?
For meddling in a deal after his close, Jim.
Well, it is a moral quandary. Jeff, I just want to say that I know how hard you've worked to get to where you are, and to throw it all away, just to do the right thing. I admire you.
Well, they say goodness is its own reward. And if a good man perseveres, he can leave the world a better place than he found it.
You have to get out of here. I know a shelter where you'll be safe, where he can't find you.
Come on, man.
Anna, get-
Get out. Get out.
Ray.
Get out.
Ray.
Open the door. I want to talk to you. Anna, talk to me about this. Anna, don't listen to this. Unlock the car. Anna.
Relationships can be so tenuous, so fragile. It's a wonder any of us ever stay married.
Mr. Grayson, Ray Kestrel on three.
Ray, how are you?
I'm a curious Chaz. That's how I am. I'm curious as to what makes you tick. Now, we both know just how badly you wanted this deal. So badly that you get the guy who mugged you to confess to everything. And once the deal is signed, you send your dog of war over here and he takes my life away.
Ray, I don't even have a remote idea of what you're talking about.
Sykes, he works for you, doesn't he?
Sykes. What did he do?
Jim. I think you know I never wanted to hire Sykes. Last thing we need right now is some ego do-gooder throwing wrenches. But the board loves him, and the press loves him. So when he does something incredibly stupid like harassing Ray Kestrel, our newest acquisition, on the very day after the merger closes, I get very upset. Because you should have known about it, and you should have stopped him. And from now on, you will. Do we understand each other? Good.
I suppose we shouldn't be surprised when the best laid plans of mice and men backfire. After all, human beings aren't machines. They have souls. They know great joy and inconsolable grief. What I admire most about some people is how passionately they pursue the things that are just outside their reach. That pursuit can begin to take control of the person's every thought. And anyone who thinks controlling people is a science is dead wrong. It's an art.